Welcome to our little Netflix kind of House of Cards, welcoming Charlie Cox, the newest member of Netflix, but also the newest member of the Marvel world and the star of Marvel's Daredevil. How would you describe Daredevil, the show?
It's very ambitious. It's kind of new for Marvel. It's geared towards a slightly older audience, so it has thematically and tonally, it's very mature. Which brings me to my first question. Who is Frank Underwood's favorite superhero? Or a superpower?
Or if Frank Underwood had a superpower?
Yeah.
Oh, but he does. And he calls it Claire.
Yeah, does
he? All right, so wait, I have a question for you. Yeah. What moment in the show you're most excited for fans to see?
There is a scene at the end of episode 2, which is one long tracking shot. It's kind of an homage to The Raid or to a very famous scene in Old Boy. Question for you, what do you watch on Netflix? What are you watching at the moment on Netflix? What are your...
I like being able to sort of catch up on series that I didn't see when they were originally on their own networks, and you know, certainly it's yeah. true with Breaking Bad and some of the others.
Yes,
but
yeah,
you know, Ricky Gervais's show is hilarious.
I haven't seen that yet. I'm very excited.
It's hilarious. All right, let's talk for a sec, if I can, about Vince D'Onofrio's character.
Yes.
Wilson Fisk.
Yes.
Any similarities to the character I play on House of Cards?
When we went to Comic-Con, Vincent was asked a question, and he said, Wilson Fisk is a child and a monster. And when he said it, it was like the hairs on the back of my neck stood up. It was terrifying. I'm interested when you speak to the audience, you speak to the camera.
Yeah.
The angle is a very specific, interesting angle.
We'll often talk about what would be the easiest place for you to do it. Is it there? Is it there? Is it there? Is it there? And I'll often have something to do
right.
about where it'll be. Sometimes it's just what's easier in terms of filming
okay.
and lighting.
Yeah.
But often it's just about how easy it is to get there, to be able to look right in that lens and
right.
and talk to the audience. The weirdest thing sometimes is, though, you know, this is true when there's a glass on the lens, and very often I can see myself,
oh, wow.
which is so annoying.
Yeah.
You know, when you look and it's, I just don't want to, it's like
yeah.
talking to a mirror, it's not what you want.
Yeah.
So sometimes I ask them to take that out so I don't actually have to see myself.
Yeah.
Here's a question. What's it like playing a blind superhero?
Very difficult. Well, playing a blind man in general is quite difficult. And this is something that you'll understand.
No, you're supposed to be blind.
I wouldn't be able to see them. So,
yes, all right.
When I worked with a blind coach, a guy who's been legally blind for 20 years, and the way that this man Joe looks at me is when he's looking, he's not looking in my eyes, but he's looking where the sound is coming from. So he's
uh-huh.
looking around my mouth or my chin. So I thought, great, that's what I'll do. The problem is, I didn't anticipate that the camera is very rarely a POV.
Right.
Camera's all, as it is here, it's over the shoulder. So when I look at you and I look at your mouth, on the camera, it looks like I'm looking at you in the eyes.
What's the most daredevil thing you've done in real life?
I bungee jumped once. They go, 3, 2, 1, and then you go. And right before I went, this guy behind me goes, wait, one second.
Oh, no.
And so the entire way down, you're like, I'm surprised they didn't have a heart
attack. Something was wrong.
You know?
Yeah.
So unbelievable.
That's a fun thing to do on sets also with an actor. Like you do
yeah.
this. So literally, Jack Lemmon used to do this to me. They'd roll, rolling. Okay, Slade. And Jack would go, you're going to really wear that tie? And then you go, rolling. God, what's wrong?
One of my first films was with Heath Ledger, and literally the first day, I didn't know the guy at all, literally the first day, he said, oh, you're going to do it like that? I was like...
He was fucking with you.
Yeah, yeah, completely. Yeah.
So is Daredevil going to kick ass or what? From
yes.
your trailer, it looks like you take a beating.
I do take a beating. It's one of the things... Oh, I'm going to get one of them in a minute.
Mm.
It's one of the things I'm most excited about this show is the great thing about Daredevil is he doesn't have any superpowers, per se.
Does he have a Netflix subscription?
He does have a
Well, then he's going to be fine.
Is Claire going to kick Frank Underwood's ass?
She will kick it, and then she'll rub it.
Yeah.
Here's my final question to you. Do you think the ends justify the means with Matt Murdock's violent actions?
Oh, come on.
That
was an easy one.
That was such an easy one.
I don't think it's fair to answer that question, and I'll tell you why, because I
All
think
right, one more time.
God, they're kind of weirdly shaped.
Are they?
Just go slowly. I got it.
Yeah,
I got
there's
it.
Your superhero,
not only
folks.
Did I get it,
tune
I got
in
it, and I
for
looked cool
superhero grabs.
I may have missed them, but at least when I got it, I looked really cool. That's important here. What's the secret to emoting an air of sexiness and dangerousness simultaneously? Oh, that was so good. Especially on that question as well. I'm so gutted.
I would say this. You know, having a girl like Robin Wright on your side.
Yeah.
Because you don't have to do much. People just go, wow, it's so sexy.
Yeah.
Boom.
I did.
Nicely
Boom.
Done.
I did it. Sir, Mr. President, thank you. Oh, can we end on this?
Yeah, what? Oh, certainly. I have a...
Yeah.
Okay.
We're survivors.